I won. Good day to you, ladies and gentlemen. So I wanted to make this piece in English as well. One of the themes that I want to focus on, in fact, the key theme that I want to talk about in this video, is this major issue around the globe that is now prominently labeled as coronavirus anxiety. What do you mean by this? Now, coronavirus anxiety is said to be caused by two main reasons. One is this change that we are facing. We've had to change from our routine life. And as you know, change is not something that the human species is very comfortable with. In fact, you, me, none of us are very comfortable with change. Resistance to change and how do you specialize in effectively changing, these are things that I usually talk about in my training sessions as well. So change is one of the key reasons. And on the other end, we have this unprecedented level of uncertainty that we are dealing with at the moment. The coronavirus pandemic is nothing like what the earth, what the planet, and what the human species has ever seen before. We have never faced this sort of a problem, this sort of a pandemic, this sort of a virus that spreads this fast. I believe that the R-note is not identified even. So this is a major issue. Because of this, what happens is we can get feelings like hopelessness. Our plans would have all been, you know, just bombarded out of place. We are not able to follow through them. We are facing high levels of stress, and we are even one of the key issues that around the globe that I've been reading a lot about that people are facing is loneliness. People feel very much lonely. In fact, I have a few friends who are stuck in Colombo who are unable to come to their homes because of the curfew, but they are alone and they're feeling this as well. So how do we deal with this? I thought that in this video, I could talk about or I could share 7 tips, so to speak, that would help you, me, all of us deal with this problem together that is generally referred to as coronavirus anxiety. Tip number one is the understanding, is the revelation and the acceptance of the fact that we are not alone. You are not alone. I am not alone. So we are facing this problem together. In fact, if you log into one of the international news outlets, you'll realize that this problem is something that the entire globe, the entire world is facing. In that sense, the first step toward dealing with anxiety is to understand that you or me, we are not dealing with this problem alone, which means you have me and I have you. The second pointer I want to share with you is that we are getting a lot of news. We have access to a lot of information regarding this coronavirus. Now, if you take Sri Lanka, the dissemination of information, especially through social media and certain apps like WhatsApp, it's not censored or it's not, there is no proper mechanism where you see a lot of uncensored or, you know, unregulated information coming across. Now, even today in the morning, I listened to this WhatsApp audio of a lady speaking for 10 minutes about how some of the people who passed away due to the coronavirus pandemic are not actually coronavirus patients. And, you know, a whole lot of bullshit, if you ask me, a whole lot of things that person shouldn't have said that would induce negative feelings in another person. You see this happening every single day by certain opportunistic people, which is why the second pointer is we need to absorb content very carefully, very responsibly at this crucial juncture that the entire human species is facing. On that note, I'd like to share, I've spoken about this before as well. The idea is that we can try to access the World Health Organization news outlets, their website or their social media campaigns. Or on the other end, a major news outlet or outlets in Sri Lanka, or I prefer certain international news outlets as well, where we can try to tap into or try to access information from. That's your second pointer. Third pointer is it's very important to stay connected. To stay connected with your family, to stay connected with your friends, to stay connected with your work colleagues. So you try to stay connected by various means. Technology has made this possible for us today. So always try to stay connected. But one very important thing I want to share here is you need to try and look for positive reinforcement. In this case, if you're talking to somebody and if that person is a highly negative person, and after 10 minutes of a phone call, if you feel down, if you feel worse than compared to when you started the phone call, then that person might be a person, at least on a temporary basis, you might want to avoid so that you can recover and perhaps help that person by means of, if you can, yourself or through another friend, through a video call, through a conference call. I know for a fact that Zoom cocktails are a very popular idea these days. Everybody's using Zoom, about 250 million daily users a day. So, you know, you try to help others, but that has to happen in the most positive way possible. The fourth tip is to, very importantly, stay healthy. Arogya parama labha. So what the point here is to be mentally fit. The most important factor is we also need to make sure that we are physically fit. How do you stay physically fit? Through the nutrition that you input to your body. Other than that, try and find a way to do some exercises every day. There are YouTube videos, certain trainers are uploading, you know, self-train content. There are apps, you can use them. And try to spend about 15 to 30 minutes every day doing a few stretching exercises. But make sure that you try and spend some time on your physical well-being as well. One important fact here is, in terms of looking after your body and your mind, try not to, or in fact, it's a major request, try not to use cigarettes or alcohol or any other kind of drugs as an outlet to feel good. I know that, take it from experience, I understand that there might be certain benefits in terms of feeling good if you use these kind of things, but the problem is they are very temporary. They don't make you feel good, or they don't help you in the long run. It'll only make a problem worse. So in that sense, I'd like to request, if any of you are looking to, or if you're using these kind of outlets to feel better, I would suggest you to try and move away from those kind of ways and tap into certain more positive and long-term methods of dealing with that kind of issue. The fifth pointer I want to share with you is, you need to focus. In fact, we all need to focus on what we can control. So if you take, for example, the past, it's slipped out of our control, you know, we cannot change it. We cannot do anything about it. If I could, I would go and change a lot of things in the past, but we can't. And on the other end, we cannot always worry about what's going to happen in the future. We are living in a world that is on a daily basis facing unprecedented levels of uncertainty. So we cannot really focus too much about the future and planning for the future. So what we need to focus here is on the present. What are we doing in the today and the now? What can we do? Now take, for example, I have a few friends who lost their jobs, right? Couple of friends who had to face pay cuts, and the pay cuts haven't been very helpful. They're facing really big challenges in terms of survival. Now, what we did, one of the methods that we tried to focus on was by looking at the present and figuring out alternative ways of how we can deal with this problem. And one very obvious arena that we looked at was online jobs. And a couple of them actually have started writing. There are plenty of online opportunities. If you face certain financial problems, and if you think you have the aptitude, if you think you have been able to collect certain skills, you have acquired certain skills that will help you in these kind of situations, I suggest you do a little bit of internet research. I can help you out, reach out to me, and I can connect you with certain opportunities where you try to tap into certain online revenue streams. So, you know, there are opportunities. There's this saying that when one door closes, another opens. In fact, my view on this is there are other doors, but the problem is when one door is open, we're just only focused on that. We don't see the rest. And take it from my experience, when that door closes, I've realized in my life that there are 1,000 other doors. So you can definitely use this as an opportunity if you have that aptitude, or build that skill into you. The sixth pointer is to focus on breathing and your smile, actually laughter. So a good breath is always very helpful, and it has helped me a lot. I talk a lot about breath. In fact, I can share with you my teachers, my trainers, my mentors, clips, instructions on how to use meditation and breathing in tandem, and how to use it in a way that reinforces your mind in a positive and resilient way. Other than that, I know that many of you are using, watching YouTube videos, sharing content, watching movies, you know, accessing various kinds of content. Now, any opportunity that you get to laugh, you know, don't miss it. In fact, don't just, you know, have a normal laugh. If you get an opportunity to laugh, laugh out loud, lol, so to speak. Make the maximum use of it. Laughter purifies our body. Laughter purifies our blood. It definitely helps us purify our mind. So it's a very positive thing. Don't miss that opportunity. And finally, be determined and be courageous. Courageous and determination are inherent to Sri Lankans. You know, we have that in our body. We face so many challenges and we face them together. So on that note, I'd like to request all of you, to suggest all of you to be courageous and to be determined. We need not go far away. Just take a look at the Sri Lanka's Tri-forces, the Sri Lankan police, the healthcare system, and all the other essential service providers to us. They enable us this safe environment of staying at home. And would they be able to function at this very optimal level, where the entire world is looking at Sri Lanka and trying to figure out how we are doing this? After several weeks, we are still in stage 3. We still haven't gone to that community spread level, and the Sri Lankan army, all these people, including the government and including the healthcare system, everybody is doing a wonderful job. So using this opportunity to thank all of them, I'd like to tell you that the 7th pointer, developing a high level of determination and being courageous, is something that we can definitely learn from them. So everything that I used with regard to developing this video, any links, any content related, I will definitely include it in the captions. So make sure, I hope that these 7 pointers, these 7 tips will expand your thought process if you're dealing with certain anxieties around the challenges you're facing with respect to the coronavirus. In fact, if you feel alone, if you think you're alone, trust me, you're not. You can always reach out to me and we can always work together. On that note, I hope you learned something, and all the very best. Aibuan.